Restaurant industry actually is blood, sweat and tears. So if you are hands-on in this industry, you have to really get your hands dirty. So it's a lot of hard work.
By normal F&B rules, JUJU is a concept that shouldn't work. CC's not a professionally trained chef, the restaurant's entrance is hidden in an alley, and there's no sign, and the place only sits 12 people. But it works, and it's awesome. CC's incredible passion and respect for food and ingredients has allowed him to create one of Malaysia's most unique dining experiences. He redefines private dining by constantly challenging diners' expectations and preconceived notions about locally sourced ingredients. So say for example, Penang cod fish can't be made into delicious sashimi, think again. Or something simple like a fried wonton that contains Malaysian made cheese won't blow your mind, think again. CC breaks down so many walls and barriers with his cooking, and that's why we think JUJU Lounge is Droolworthy.
I started from my home kitchen, where my mom gave me a lot of freedom and chance for me to be in the kitchen to help her. At one time, I was even tasked to cook for the whole family for a short period of time. So probably that early age where being exposed in the kitchen, it slowly built my interest in cooking in the future. I could say that my mom kick-started all this. She also managed to set the benchmark for what is good cooking, what is good food. I would say I'm very blessed to have tasted a lot of good food from her kitchen. The reason why I'm more interested or more inclined to move towards Mediterranean countries in my cooking is because of their simplicity. I was actually very inspired when I was in Spain and Portugal, where they really let the ingredients shine, minimal intervention in the food, but the food tastes great. I would say if I can do something or my approach to cooking can be that way, just let my ingredients shine and then you have minimal intervention, and but it can create a bigger impact than a typical sauce heavy Chinese cuisine. When I present you with a plate, it might look very simple and bare at times, but what I want to show is that you can have something that simple, but when you taste it, and if it can ignite a sensation or some questions in you when you eat it, and I feel I managed to create a dialogue. I want my ingredients to shine, even the simplest or the humblest fish. Certain dish that I create might be inspired by what I've seen in my travels, but I'm moving towards sourcing local ingredients and try to do a twist to it in a Mediterranean style or create a new combination of things with what we have locally here. The food that many people would go for repeat orders, probably like pork and lala, done in the Alentejano style, which is a very traditional Portuguese cooking where you mix pork and clams. That is something interesting that people haven't tasted before, especially in the local context here. I believe if I can consistently serve good food with honest approach, with freshest ingredient you can get hold of, and occasionally with some new twists and new flavors, I feel it's a restaurant to stay.